As some of you know, my focus for quite a few years now has been Songs of the Irish, the Civil War. Got two albums out of that. I'd like to do a couple from my first album. There was a character in New York during the Civil War by the name of Joe English. He was not English, he was Irish Catholic off the boat. And as many of you know, the Irish Catholics during the mid-19th century were essentially the famine Irish. They were not treated so well, they were often met with galling prejudice. And they came up with these characters called stage Irish characters. Now they were sort of capturing their own reputation back because their detractors came up with their versions of stage Irish characters who were very negative buffoons. And of course the Irish came up with their own versions who were of course heroic and funny and noble. Everything they just saw themselves as being. And this song is called My Father's Gone. It features a fellow by the name of Paddy Carney from Killarney. Now, Paddy Carney appears in a couple of songs in different units. In this case, he's in Mahoney Irish Brigade, the 69th New York. It's written to an old melody, Paddy's Wedding. Okay, I've been known to do that. Come listen now, I tell you how I came to leave Kincaid. I'm one of the boys that gave me his name is Paddy Carney. Was raised a hubbub, a woman's hunter took possession. Instead of a flag, they raised the rag, the standard of secession. And it's then I joined the 69th, my father's gone to shoulder. And he said, you know, it's not the door, yet I'm not one before. Oh, I want to see them all, my name's Glory. With my father's gone, my father's gone, I'm on my way to glory. I missed it then with my horse, then the rebels found me shooting up. The boat remained outside to make some aim at that good duty go. Then boys, step up the phone to that, I'll lead you on to glory. And if you get the brother to spit your name, we leave it so we go. Oh, I come to see the man to be my name, it's so we go. When my father's gone, I follow the drum. By the British, they were threatening to intervene early in the war. Now there are chapters of these fellows all across the North called Fenians. And the Fenians were the American branch of the Irish Republican Brotherhood, which is the predecessor to the IRA, the modern IRA. And when these Fenian fellows caught wind of the notion that the British might get into this war, they sort of evaporated, entire chapters just evaporated as they enlisted in the Union Army, thinking they may be fighting their old traditional enemy of old, John Bull, which is, of course, Great Britain. It has to be remembered that these were men who had survived or barely survived the famine. And that, combined with 700 years plus of British oppression, they're not feeling too kindly towards the English. But it sort of echoes all the reasons General Maher used to recruit the Irish Brigade. The opinions of Paddy McGee. I'm Paddy McGee, swim from down on a hazer in an elegant ship like a horse. Father Don the horse sent me my passage. He left me shore only for that I walked away. He talked of a miracle's freedom and glory. But Lord says I, that's the country for me. Such a wind and long story, I come now before you to give me a appointments of Paddy McGee. When Ireland was needing and famine was fading and thousands were dying for something to wait, 'twas America's doctors that sent o'er the waters the ships that were loaded with corn and wheat. And Irishmen shall forever remember the vessels that carried the flag, the freedom, and the land that befriended their land to defend it. And that's the opinions of Paddy McGee. Well, I'm sure men are older, the musket to shoulder, enlisting the longest soldier in trade. With Cochrane fighting in Maher delighting, they swell up the ranks of the Irish Brigade. With Columbia defying the British line, the sons of old Ireland forever have been. I've no intervention if that's their intention. Now that's the opinions of Paddy. John Bull, you devil, you better keep civil. Remember the story of 76, when Washington glorious, he smothered the Tories. Away from Columbia, you then cut your sticks. And if once again you're inclined to be meddling, there's a city that's called you for beans, did you see? Where Hickory Jackson, he drove up the Saxon. Now that's the opinions of Paddy. Although we're in trouble, it's only a bubble. We'll soon make the foes of the Union tire. For the names that would meddle had better skedaddle, for that Uncle Sam has a taste of great fire. They'll find it, they try it, cut up his DI. A victory punched on the flag of the free, but the American nation can wait on creation. Now that's the opinion.